Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to look at Restream and how you can use this to create live streams to your audience over on YouTube. Without further ado, let's jump into today's video. So guys, first thing we're going to do is jump across to Restream.io, which is linked down below in the description. It's a paid service, but there are also free trials available. So make sure you head through that link if you want the very best deal now. What you will then brought over to is this front page here. You can see there's a number of different things that we can do with this software. So first of all, we can see here, start with studio, so I can live stream it through a studio. This is a great way to connect different people in different areas through one studio and then into a live stream if that's something you want to do. You can also then do things like sharing your screen with OBS, Zoom, etc. And then you can also stream live a pre-recorded video file, which you can see here. So first of all, we're just going to look at that one. And you can see that I can send information to these different links in a variety of different ways. So for example, if I click on start with studio, then it's going to bring me to a page like this. And what's cool about this is I can also create a studio so people all around the world can join into one studio that's being streamed through one YouTube channel. So that's very, very powerful indeed, because then you can have different group conferences, whatever, that's all being streamed through one platform rather than having to produce separate videos, link them all together and then put it through. This is a really cool way to do things. Another cool thing we can click on is stream a video file. Then we can download a video here. Click on next, and then I can create the event, test one, and then a description down below. Obviously, I'm not going to actually launch this onto my channel, guys, but you can understand the title descriptions as you would do normally on YouTube. Click and create thumbnail, click on next, and then you can see that it's going to launch onto the channel that I have selected for. At the moment, this is on a free trial, so you can only do a minimum of 500 megabytes per video, but if you wanted to do more, it's obviously going to be a paid plan that you need. Another very, very cool feature is this here. So what this allows you to do is share either your screen through OBS software, but we're going to look at OBS because I think that's probably the most useful one here. So go across to obsproject.com. If you don't know what OBS is, guys, it's pretty much like what I'm using now. It's not what I'm using now, but in order to share my screen with you, I'm using a software very much like OBS, but OBS is the best free version that you can get. If you click on Windows, Mac, whatever computer you're using, you can then download the appropriate OBS software. Now, what I then need to do, guys, jumping over to my dashboard in YouTube, I can then go and create a live stream event. Okay, so schedule stream, and we're gonna click on streaming software. Then I can go and fill out all of the details for this. So we're just gonna put in that. Obviously this is description stuff and I can go and put everything in down below. You can see that my YouTube is now ready to start the stream. Now obviously this is currently live. You can set up a scheduled meeting and when you want it to actually launch. It's always best to have it kind of set up and ready to go before you're gonna try and go live. I just wanna show you the process by which all of this happens. So now we've set all of that up, we then need to feed the information into the YouTube studio from Restream and from OBS to Restream. Okay, so I hope that makes sense. So now we're gonna go to the original part of this. OBS Studio, download OBS, Windows, Mac, whatever it is, guys, and then open OBS. What you need to do once you're inside OBS is very important, but very easy indeed. So obviously once you've set up all the sources and stuff, which you can do through following an OBS tutorial, which will be available online, is click setting and then click on stream. And you can see that I've already input this information. Now the way to find that information is to go and set up your live stream. You need to copy RTMP URL, which goes in as the server up here, and then you copy the stream key, and then that goes in where it says stream key. Very straightforward. So once I've done that, I just click OK, and then this is now all linked up. So my OBS is now gonna go to Restream. Restream is then gonna send it to YouTube. Hope that all makes sense. Now what we're gonna do is click Start Streaming, and then jumping back to Restream, it's gonna pop up and populate this window if everything is running correctly. Now you do need good Wi-Fi connection for this, guys. You do need good upload speed, and like while people will tell you like 5 megabytes, 6 megabytes per second is fine, you realistically need like 10-15% minimum in order to be able to stream effectively. It also would help if you've got another way to view that you're streaming, like a phone or an iPad or whatever, so that you can see everything that's going on, or another monitor, and then you can see everything very easily. It is quite challenging to do live streams, but once you get them set up, guys, they can be really rewarding and help you to build your channel. So you can see, obviously, this is my live stream now going through here. At the moment, I haven't forwarded it on to YouTube, and all I need to do is click on this one here. Okay, so what I want to do, guys, is click here where it says Edit Destinations. And remember, we just created a new event in here. And I can click on that drop down, and it's going to bring me across to the one I wanted to put in, which was Test 02. And then I'm going to click on Save. You can see that it's now sending data to Test 02. So everything is now running through. Everything is perfect, guys. You can see that this is lagging slightly behind what I'm talking about, but that's obviously no real problem, guys. And all of the information that you need is all provided here. So this is an excellent way that you can stream from OBS into Restream, into YouTube, keeping control of everything that's going on. Remember to schedule your live streams. Give yourself plenty of time to set this up, guys. If you've never done it before, it can be very tricky to get yourself set up. Restream does make things a lot easier, so go and try it out. Link down below in the description. OBS, obviously another fantastic software that does take a little bit of time to set up, but there's plenty of amazing tutorials on how to do that, which will help you to prepare for your live streams effectively. But live streams are a great way for you to build your subscriber count and to improve your YouTube channel, earning potentially more returns in future. So in summary, guys, this is taking me about 5 minutes, and I've now already set up a full live stream that can then go onto my channel. One of the benefits of using live streams over actual other videos is that you don't have to go and do lots of editing afterwards. It's very much handier that way, and you can engage more with your viewers. If you enjoyed today's video, guys, make sure you smash the thumbs up button. It helps us out more than you know. Thanks for doing that. And if you're new to the channel and you want to learn more about how to do things like live stream, how to find some of the very best digital products online, then make sure you subscribe to be kept up to date with all of the latest happening. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you soon in the next one. Bye-bye.